3 days, they packed in so much fun.
A lot of laughing, a lot of smiling. That'll be amazing.
It's a no-brainer. Travel the world, meet people. This was the best thing that ever happened to me.
You're listening to the Dream Trips Podcast.
And welcome to another episode of the Dream Trips Podcast. My name's Wayne McMullen, I'm your host, and I'm joined by my exceptionally dramatic and pragmatic co-host, Miss Hannah de Klerk. Hiya, Hannah!
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way.
Oh my gosh, it's that time of the year.
Oh, what fun it is to... You know me. That I get overly excited about Christmas.
You do.
I'm sorry.
I love it as an Irishman as well. And even though it's Christmas and it's a Christian holiday and everything, and we celebrate it here in the States and you know, in a lot of other countries, I'm sure our people out there, our members, our listeners, really want to get in the Christmas spirit, which is really all about being joyful and giving and just being nice to each other, right?
Well, absolutely. And that is a huge part of our company, too, is just, you know, capturing culture. And in the United States, a big part of the culture is Christmas.
It is. Mm-hmm. But we did get a very early Christmas present this year, didn't we, from our best friend over there at WV Live, Scott Caldwell.
Oh, my goodness. Yes. Christmas come early. It was so exciting.
I know. That was nice. If you guys didn't see it on WV Live, we actually starred in 11 minutes and 30 seconds in.
But here's the big part of it. For those who do watch it, they might have a question about what he introduced you as, which is mutton chops. And for those who don't know, please explain this.
I guess the easiest way would be to go to our microsite and actually see the photographs of Meet the Team. But I've got this set of Edwardian mutton chops that I sport. And a set of Edwardian mutton chops, which kind of encompass the sides of my face and attach to my mustache. And they're really quite regal, I think.
And people wonder why I stereotype you with the top hat and the cane.
Okay, I'm a Dickens character. That's basically what it is. I'm a Dickens character.
Christmas crass. I don't know.
Ghost of Christmas crass?
The ghost of Christmas. I don't know.
I actually kind of like that. I think I'm going to call myself that from now on. But you know what? Let's get back down to business here and let's talk to them about what this episode is about, because we've got a really cool episode coming up, and it's part two of a two-part series, right?
And it's very exciting. I know for me personally and, you know, my previous experience with working with Dream Trips and helping build Dream Trips, that there is a lot of work and preparation that goes into building one of these.
There really is. And we're actually going to hear from those people in this particular episode. And we're going to hear from the builders, the arrangers, the people on the ground that really make Dream Trips membership so special.
You don't realize that a lot does go into it. It's exciting. It's exciting to share it.
Let's share it then. I've got a wonderful interview with somebody from Rovia who's actually going to be talking about what goes into putting a real Dream Trip together. So should we just hit the go button?
Hit go.
Today's feature.
And my feature interview today is with a wonderful person from Rovia, which is, of course, is our travel department here. And her name is Dina Siddiqui, and she's the Senior Manager of Dream Trips Marketing and Development. Wow, that's a title.
We have these huge titles at Rovia.
We spoke to one of our members on the last episode that talked about a bunch of different things that happen in Africa. And when I got in touch with Rovia, they said, you know, if you're looking for an expert on Africa and how to build a dream trip over in that particular area, there's only one person in the world to speak to, and that's our Dina Siddiqui. So how does it feel that you've got that sort of reputation, Dina?
It's a lot to live up to, and I don't know about in the world.
Well, in our world. In our world. So, you know, tell me one thing. What does a Dream Trips Marketing and Development Senior Manager do?
Well, that's a great question. It's actually, we set the direction, the strategy for how we're going to have Dream Trips, the inventory of Dream Trips, and we try and stay ahead so that we have at least 15 months worth of product.
Oh, wow, that's a long time.
It is. And we, you know, and because of our phenomenal growth in this market, we really have found that now we have the capacity to have more rooms and plan with our members' input. You know, we can definitely have enough trips out there for at least even 2 years.
You actually specialize quite a bit in the African continent, correct?
I do, Africa and Middle East.
Okay, so tell me this, what would you say is our most popular dream trip in that area?
I would say anything to do in Cape Town. We have a lot of great options and variety of trips. So it's like ranging from our cruises to overland, you know, safaris.
Oh, wow.
And hot air balloon. That's one thing that we've just done in the last year.
You know, that's funny. I was talking to a great member and a great friend of mine, Anand Patel, probably a couple of episodes ago. And he actually talked about doing some hot air ballooning, and it sounded incredible. There must be an awful lot that goes into organizing something like that.
There really is. And there's a lot of people on the ground that help us just with input on what's the best type of excursion that our members want, as well as what's going to work in different weather and temperature. You know, we have to take a lot of things into consideration.
Got you. Give me an example of one destination that was actually given to you by a member.
I would say the zip lining at Muggleesburg, you know, which are the mountains. And what a phenomenal dream trip. But just because we were able to sell it out so many times over. And it was actually from our Kenya members.
Oh, wow.
That wanted to go on such a thing. And, you know, because we're always looking for activities that our members wouldn't be able to easily arrange on their own.
Gotcha.
So it's like really a bucket list kind of activity that we want, like once in a lifetime.
That's the great thing about Dream Trips, of course, is that, you know, it's all kind of done for you. And that doesn't happen overnight, does it? I mean, there's an awful lot that goes into arranging everything for a dream trip.
No, you're exactly right. There's a lot that goes into it, and many departments, you know, work together to create this bucket list dream trip. There's marketing, there's procurement, there's in-destination support, there's customer service that, are really valuable input that we get from them as well. And it's important to know that a dream trip doesn't just end at the conclusion of a dream trip. It actually, there's so much more that goes into it. And we're always engaged with the customer from beginning to end.
If I'm working in your department and I get a suggestion from maybe one of our high-profile members who says, you know, I'd really like to go on a dream trip to such and such a place. How do you go about researching and making sure that that place is, you know, up to our standards and that it would actually work for our dream trips?
No, that's a great question. We're actually all blessed because we have product development people that are in destination. So they're locals. So they're in South Africa, they're based in Zimbabwe. And so what they do is that they look at it from a local person's perspective.
Oh, interesting.
And so they are experts in their region in overland safari, and they're able to really visit the place that we're talking about so that it's not just a something that has not been tried and true. So we do site visits on every single dream trip that we create.
Well, that's good to me, because I often pictured that maybe you guys just Google it and then you just travel to it on the internet. But no, you guys actually put feet to the floor and go out there and tread and see whether it is going to be up to standard, right?
So that would be one of the cool things about being a member, is that we actually have experts that are from that country, and we are able to visit the dream trip and actually go on one ourselves and before we can recommend it, you know, to our members.
Now, you've must have been on a few dream trips in your time. So what would you say was your favorite dream trip that you had over there?
I think one of my favorite ones was on the Vaal River in South Africa, because it was just an unusual experience. I had no expectations. I didn't know anything about, being on a river in South Africa. It's, you know, because most people think of safari.
Exactly.
So, but just like being on a houseboat on down the Vaal River.
Oh, wow.
Was just a different view of Africa that I'm used to.
Now, when you went on that dream trip, did you come back and go, oh, that was great and this was great, but maybe I could tell them how to improve something here?
Actually, yes. Anytime any member of my team or our product development, whenever we visit any of our dream trips or anyone else's dream trip in the company, we're always looking for ways that we can have improvements and bring a different perspective.
Now, does it take a long time from concept to actually be on a dream trip? I mean, if I was to come up with an idea and say, hey, I wanted to go to this particular place, and this is where I think we should have a dream trip, how long does it generally take for you guys to figure out all of the logistics and everything and the pricing and all things of that nature until we actually start to see it on dreamtrips.com?
Now, that's a great question, and we are constantly looking at ways of shortening the time. Mm-hmm. But currently, I would say about 10 weeks.
Okay.
Because a lot of it actually depends on the contract.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the negotiating the terms and making sure that it's up to our standards.
Gotcha.
Because, we are very adamant that we don't compromise on our 4-star or better standard, mm-hmm. as well as the savings to our member.
Now, do you ever go to places where somebody has perhaps suggested it and you get there and just go, this just isn't going to cut it?
Yes. And, and one example would be like Mozambique, mm-hmm. which we love having dream trips there. And it's a great, it's in high demand and a wonderful location. But we are always struggling to find high quality.
Gotcha.
High quality accommodations, and we have finally improved on that, but that is, we will never sacrifice quality to get a good trip.
Well, that's really good to hear. That's mm-hmm. great to hear. Now, you obviously come across challenges. What would you say are some of the challenges that you encounter in your day-to-day running over there in Rovia?
I would say time. Mm-hmm. Time and the number of activities that all of my, myself included, all my team members and myself have to work on. So basically it's, finding the time to put in to every single dream trip and making sure that it's a exceptional value that cannot be replicated.
Wow, time, that's a big one, isn't it? We always say all the time to our members, take the time to really enjoy yourselves and pick where you go and take a lot of time on that. But it really does, it wraps into the whole concept of making a dream trip really more than a vacation, doesn't it?
It really does, because, a dream trip is something that should really impact your life.
Mm-hmm.
It should impact it by the people that you meet, the kind of experiences that you have and the feelings that you have at the conclusion of that dream trip.
What do you wish for dream trips in the future? Because you're over there and you see what we're working on, and I'm not going to ask you to release any state secrets here. That's for definite. But what excites you about dream trips and where you see it might be going?
I would say the variety, mm-hmm. because every dream trip needs to be customized in a perfect world to the target member. It should really tick off everyone's bucket list. And so if I can create a customized experience for you as a member, that would be my goal.
That's a great goal. Now, you've obviously been with Rovia for a long time. How long have you actually been in this line of work?
I have been in the travel industry for many years, but...
She's not going to tell us.
Because then I'd have to tell you how old
I am. Okay, well, we won't push you on that then.
No, but with Rovia for 2 years.
Uh-huh.
But I've been, I've lived in about 7 or 8 countries growing up. So I've kind of always had this in the back of my mind of how to create a perfect trip.
It's funny, there are a number of us here at the company that have got very diverse backgrounds. And I think a lot of people think, oh, that little company in Plano, Texas is probably all Texans in there. Well, it really isn't. I mean, there are people like yourself and myself that are from all over the world. And we add our colors to the whole equation. Dina Siddiqui, who is the Senior Manager for Dream Trips Marketing and Development, thank you so much for joining us today on the Dream Trips podcast.
Oh, I enjoyed it. Thank you for having me.
Today's feature.
I really enjoyed listening to that piece with Dina. I mean, she is such a wonderful, kind person. And I know just in the past working with her, she's mm-hmm. just great. She's wonderful.
Well, she certainly was very giving and really informative. I mean, that was a great thing. And she's actually obviously from that part of the world.
Yeah. And which, by the way, I don't know if you want to talk a little bit about our numbers and some of the cool updates and about Democrats. Yeah.
That it was really surprising to me that one of our largest listening areas is actually in Nairobi, Kenya.
So shout out to you all.
Thank you so much. Keep on listening.
Yes.
And of course, the US is way up there, way up there, followed closely behind by Australia and Asia. But that was a shock to me that it was Nairobi. And we'll keep on listening, guys. We really appreciate it. Well, you know what? Let's just go into our social beat then, shall we? Because Jason and I actually had some really great things that we talked about. And Jason, I gave him a new title during this next segment. And so have a listen to it. It's kind of fun.
The social beat.
So here we are again on the social beat, and I'm here with the king of social media for the DreamTrips podcast, Mr. Jason Clayton. Hello, Jason, me old mate.
So what's up with this throne, Wayne? you've given me over here.
What can I say? You know, I know nothing about social media, other than the fact that I know how to post probably, and that's about it. But you are the resident expert here at the company on how to get the most out of social media with DreamTrips, and that's why we've got you, of course. You guys over there in social media, you've got so much going on now. I mean, you just launched the whole Snapchat account. How did that go down, by the way?
Yeah, so we actually launched Snapchat in Las Vegas, and it was just an incredible way for us to extend our reach to this growing platform, you know, with over 150 million active users. This is really something that we wanted to expand, you know, have more conversations with our audience members, as well as, you know, the outside community. Snapchat is really an extraordinary new platform, and we're already seeing some amazing stories that you, our members, are sharing with us. And we're looking forward to doing some exciting things with that in the future.
So let me start off with, you know, of course, you know, number one, how on earth do you follow DreamTrips on social media?
Where do I start? I mean, we have so many great platforms and opportunities for you to really interact and engage with us. What I would say is really look at what you enjoy using on a daily basis. If you're just on Facebook, you know, we have a great community on Facebook. It is just at DreamTrips, so you can find us by simply using the @ and then DreamTrips. We also have a great presence on Twitter as well. For instance, with Twitter, we're posting a little bit more news updates, you know, what's new, what's happening.
Yeah, I use it for like my news sources. That's really what I use Twitter for. If I want to find out what's going on in the world, I hit Twitter and I check it out, what's happening.
Yeah, and you know, a lot of times the first news really hits Twitter. So this is really something that we incorporate to leverage what are some of the exciting updates taking place in membership for DreamTrips and DTL. I would then look at the overall structure. So for instance, Instagram. The great thing about Instagram now is that they're really expanding the way in which people view content. They've released a new feature called Instagram Stories, which is a lot like Snapchat. It's allowing people to share videos, which before you may have only seen photos on Instagram. Mm-hmm. Now you're able to actually see a 3D dimension of what's taking place around the world.
Now, of course, everyone knows the old family friend Facebook.
With DreamTrips, you know, Facebook is obviously a very global social network. Mm-hmm. The content that we supply in there is global in nature. We love sharing our experiences of our members around the world. So
if they want to engage with us via one of these social media forums, I mean, how do they do that? I mean, first of all, say I'm a complete total idiot, which isn't too far a stretch of the imagination. what is a hashtag and how does a hashtag work?
Yeah, so a hashtag is a way that the social media channels and sites have actually figured out to group content.
Mm-hmm.
So whenever you're taking a dream trip, or you're visiting one of our partners with DreamTrips Local, use the hashtag to really group your content that allows us, as DTL or DreamTrips, to go ahead and discover some of the amazing experiences that you're taking, and then for us to also engage with you. With DreamTrips Local, we have a hashtag. It's Travel Your City. Mm-hmm. And Travel Your City is a way for us to actually let people know what you can do in places like New York, in Dallas, and earn points while you're doing what you would do anyways, which is dine at some of the most popular destinations For hashtags, it's a great way for us to discover the experiences that you're enjoying with us around the world. So, you know, be sure to use the hashtag based on what you're up to. So for Dream Trips, a lot of our members know the quintessential hashtag YSBH. You should be here. And essentially, this is a global hashtag. You know, we love seeing what our members are up to around the world. Mm-hmm. We see the blue sign all over the world. And love the hashtag is really something that accompanies the blue sign. Whenever you're sharing your videos and your pictures, it's just a good way for us to add that, to build a conversation, and for you to join the discussion that's happening around the world within our community. But at the same time, you know, respect the blue sign. So whenever you're using pictures or videos, make sure you avoid things like alcohol, you know, excessive drinking, parties. We want to be respectful of the blue sign. A lot of people do respect and really admire and cherish what that sign stands for mm-hmm. on social, because at the end of the day, all of the content that we put out are an extension of ourselves, and we're all brands. Yep. And so just be cautious of that. And just showcase more of the fun. The other thing that you could do as well is actually tagging us. So there's a little symbol called the @. So whenever you're sharing content on Instagram or Twitter, make sure you use that @ for Facebook. It's @DreamTripsOfficial. For Twitter, it's @DreamTrips. And then the same for Instagram. So just take a look at some of the content that you're putting out there. If you want us to share some of the experiences that you've taken recently on a dream trip, or, you know, you've had a really tasty experience at one of our DCL partners around the world, let us know. And we'll basically go ahead and engage right back with you. And then for us to actually go ahead and like and comment on the experiences that you're taking.
That's awesome. Well, listen, Jason, thank you so much for enlightening us so much about how you can really engage with us and all of the other members and everybody on Dream Trips. And thank you so much again for being the king of social media at our little podcast.
Thank you so much, Sir Wayne.
The Social Beat.
I always love to hear about, you know, the updates that we have with our social media.
Yeah, the Snapchat is really exciting. It really is.
So exciting. But most importantly, I loved your nickname for Jason.
Well, he is the king.
We always have a different title for him, but it's always very regal. Mm-hmm. And here's why. He just dresses from head to toe
impeccably.
Perfectly. Yeah, his socks. And, you know, the first time I met him, I remember he was getting coffee.
Uh-huh.
And just stirring, and he was so proper about it. And I thought, who is this guy?
Well, you know, I just heard the accent. I heard the accent. And I was like, oh, a like mind.
So I remember talking to him, and he made one of the funniest jokes, but it was so dry because his voice, you know, it's very, again, regal and
he's
royal sounding.
He's very proper. He's very proper. Should I try and do the South African for you right now? The Jason Clayton impression with my prim and proper socks.
Oh my goodness, it's great. Africa?
And I do Africa. Apologize to our South African members for doing a terrible South African accent, because I don't do it very well.
Do it again.
I'm trying right
it's
now.
It's like Africa, right?
South Africa.
It's got a little bit of a...
I can't do it. I can't do it, Hannah. It just doesn't work for me.
Well, regardless...
You know what does work for me, though?
What?
The membership spotlight works for me very well.
Very well.
Very well. It works very well. I'm going to give up on that because we've got a phenomenal membership spotlight. And Jason talked, of course, all about, you know, the fun stuff on contacting us through social media. And the one thing that we realized that he didn't really talk about too much was the Dream Trips app and how you can actually reach out to people via the Messenger.
By using the Messenger app, you can reach out to someone and, you know, even talk to someone who's local and say, hey.
Exactly.
You know, what's fun? What are some of the hot spots? Where can we go to really get a taste of the culture?
I think this is going to be a real interesting lesson for people, so they should listen real carefully for what Jim has to say.
Member Spotlight.
I'm speaking to my buddy Jim Hobart, who is the user experience consultant here for the Dream Trips app at Dream Trips. Welcome, Jim. How you doing, buddy?
I'm doing great. How you doing, Wayne?
I know that when we spoke in our last podcast episode, in the member spotlight, we had a gentleman from Ireland who was talking all about the app and how really the app worked so well for him. And he really started to touch on the messenger feature of the app. You're actually quite pivotal in designing that feature, weren't you, Jim?
Well, there was a team of us. I'm part of the user experience team, and we look at all the experiences that members go through when they're either booking a trip, going on, mm-hmm. Booking travel, using the app, and we create new and hopefully better user experiences for them to utilize the services as part of their membership. So we actually spent a lot of time just studying users and having other people in the corporate office as well walk in the user's shoes, see through their eyes, and then have the teams experience what the users are going through, and then create digital experiences to optimize whatever it is they're trying to accomplish.
So really then, there's an awful lot of back and forth that really goes into building this type of thing into an app then.
Yeah, we don't just dream up things. In fact, the Messenger, one of the genesis was when we were coming up with the different features to extend the app. But first, of course, we rolled out sharing pictures and creating all the social experiences. Mm-hmm. But another big gap we saw was that when people actually go on trips, when they're possibly even experience some sort of friction, maybe they have a delayed flight or something where they need to maybe reach to the host or reach someone else on the trip, it was kind of difficult to do. So since they're using the DreamTrips app, one of the key features we implemented right when we rolled this feature out was the auto creation of grouped DreamTrips. So what that means is that when you sign up for a DreamTrip and you have the option to opt out of this, you automatically get put into a group chat session with all the other people going on the dream trip. What we saw was it definitely helps smooth out some of the friction, but also what we're seeing is people are able to chat and communicate long before the trip starts, during the trip, and after the trip.
There's something that's built in there for me to go in and actually message people that are going to be on the same trip as me.
Absolutely. You just go in and select the messenger icon. And as soon as you go in there, you'll see that you can have one-on-one chats and group chats. You'll automatically be put into the group chat for that particular trip. Then if you did have a question, you simply jump into that chat group, post the question, you'll see all the other members in it, and one or more of them can answer you.
So I don't have to hunt for my trip in Mexico. It will just show up in the messenger portion of the app?
Better than that even. The messenger feature, you can just use Wi-Fi and you don't have to use any SMS messages or phone charges to do it.
Have you ever had need yourself to actually use this feature within the app?
I was on a trip to Mexico, and I had a delayed flight. I couldn't reach the host. This is before the messenger. Didn't mm-hmm. know how to reach her. Finally did reach her. But by the time I did, my wife and I were, still a little bit curious about who's going to pick us up and how would we get to the airport. And I definitely felt that stress that can happen. Now, that said, if I could have just jumped on a little messenger and said, hey, I'm going to be taking the next flight. So now with the messenger feature being part of that DreamTrips group chat, you'll be able to do that. And we think really resolve a lot of the friction that can happen when things happen or go awry in a trip.
Why is it that you enjoy doing this type of work?
I love traveling. I've been blessed to be able to work in over 40 different countries. And I truly believe that with our members being able to go on trips and see the world, it's going to open up all kinds of new possibilities to them. And, I've always traveled with my kids. It's opened up many their eyes as far as what, the world can offer as well.
So you obviously are big time into travel. I mean, you talk about your kids too. You're wanting to take your kids around the world. Would you say that this messenger feature within the app is something that's going to really help families and all members in their travels with Dream Trips?
Yeah, absolutely. In fact, sometimes there's other features aside from the group chat. So for instance, let's say you're in a group chat and maybe you just have a specific question, maybe regarding one of your kids, or you just have a question about something you don't want everyone to know. So you can simply tap on one of the people in the group chat and then spin off a one-on-one chat with that person. Maybe it's a host, maybe it's someone else you met on the trip. Now you've taken just a tool that makes it easier to communicate with each other, and now we're going to start building relationships.
It does take an awful lot of planning and an awful lot of execution to get this going. I mean, what on earth would we do without people like yourself and our digital team to be able to build these things?
Well, it definitely takes a team, and we're always coming up with new ideas. In fact, one of the features that we implemented within the Messenger recently, which is exciting, especially since we have a global member community, is mm-hmm. the ability to communicate across multiple languages instantly. Let me give you an example. Let's say you're on a dream trip, and maybe let's say you're looking at the Statue of Liberty, you're in New York City, and you see someone and they're standing next to you, and maybe they speak Chinese, and you speak English. And so maybe you wave to them and you're both looking at the Statue of Liberty, and you can actually send them a message. Isn't this amazing to see this, you know, maybe from a cruise ship or from the island? And he can look back at you, send a message back. And guess what? When he gets your message in English, he simply taps on it, and then it'll automatically translate it to Chinese, his native language, in the app. And then when he sends the message to you, or she sends the message to you in Chinese, you simply tap on it and it translates it to English. So you can literally have real-time conversations in 52 different languages with members around the world.
That's incredible. I mean, instant connection. I don't want to have you spill the beans on any state secrets here, but, you know, what excites you about the future of the DreamTrips app?
Let's say you're walking around the streets in New York and you discover a great little cafe and you've maybe separated from the rest of the group. You can now simply, there's a little icon, has an icon that says send, a little icon on the lower left. You simply tap on that and it'll a menu pops up and it'll say share location. When you tap on share location, it actually knows, based on the location of the phone, where you are, and it will send a picture of the map to either that person or the people in your group chat, and it'll share exactly your location. They can then get that in their group chat, tap on the map, and it'll give them directions how to get to you. So what we really want to see happen is building those digital connections that you have made with people maybe before a trip, and then when you meet them, it becomes much more enhanced. Now you actually meet people face to face. You can actually break that language barrier and hopefully even make some lifetime friends out of this.
Well, I just think it's great work that you and your team are doing, and all of the people on the digital team. Jim, thanks so much for joining us today on the DreamTrips podcast and just explaining a little bit about what goes on behind the design and the whole initiation of this incredible app.
My pleasure, Wayne, and happy travels to everyone out there. Use the Messenger app. It's a great way to connect with others on your trip, and even one-on-one. We always are looking for feedback, and we'll be continuously making it even better.
Member Spotlight.
You know, what a gift it was to get to have Jim on our podcast.
He's just he's a really smart guy, and you know what I really like about him is that even though he's one of these techie guys, he really cares about the user experience.
Yeah, he absolutely does. I mean, he even travels to different places just to talk to members and, you know, really
exactly.
get a feel about what's going on. And I know you kind of took a page out of his book, so to speak. That's
I
an
did.
Idiom.
I did. I traveled to Las Vegas.
You did.
I had a blast. I really did. And you know what? And let me first of all say that I saw so many incredible members while I was there. And got some incredible testimonials from them talking about how much they love their membership. And a big thank you to everybody that stopped by and said, hey, Wayne, what are you doing? Let me record with you. Because it really was fantastic. And we'll actually hear some of those testimonials on upcoming Dream Trips podcasts.
Which is very exciting. Mm-hmm. But you know what else is exciting?
What's that?
Dream Trips Local is now in the entertainment capital of the world.
I know, it is so cool there. I mean, Jason got to do some cool things like on the race cars there, a couple of the activities that they're trying out. Mm-hmm. And I actually got to dine at a place called Senior Frogs, which was part of Dream Trips Local. Great place, phenomenal party-like atmosphere, mm-hmm. Was taken care of incredibly well. And maybe we can hear a little bit more about Senior Frogs at one of our future episodes too, because I met some nice people there.
It would be very exciting. But now you can also dine your way toward a dream trip while being in the entertainment capital of the world.
You know what?
It's great.
It's phenomenal. I mean, of course, you know, you can't completely purchase a dream trip with your dining points unless you're executive status. But I mean, definitely, you know, you can use those points and put them towards, you know, the amount that you need for a dream trip. And I think that's phenomenal.
Could you give us like a little taste or a hint or any neat stories that you heard that stood out to you at all?
You know, the one thing that stood out to me is just how much this membership has really affected people in a positive way. And I did 52 interviews, and everybody just had such a positive thing to say about DreamTrips membership and how it has really enriched their lives and how they're just looking forward to ticking off more things off of their bucket list, which is really incredible. There are definitely some activities now that are being added to DreamTrips Local. They're not all over the world yet, mm-hmm. of course, you know, and it's in its infant stages, baby steps, baby steps, but we're looking to really expand that entertainment category in Dream Trips Local.
Yeah, and you know, that's a great part about Vegas is that, you know, of course, people think of casinos, but it's also just a cultural hub for so many different restaurants. It's great. I'm super excited that we're there. And we've almost partnered with... What is the number now?
Like 1,000 restaurants.
Like 1,000 restaurants, vendors, entertainment. Yeah, yeah, across the globe.
So hang on to your hats, folks, because if we're not in your city yet, and you know, we are going global with this, but we're not in every single place on the earth yet. So check in that app. Go hit that Discover button and figure out where there is a Dream Trips local partner that's close by to you that you can take advantage.
I'm very excited to share, you know, just... how our wonderful ambassadors were able to go out and grow Dream Trips Local so quickly.
Well, you know what? I think we should just hear it, Hannah.
Let's do it.
Dream Trips Local updates.
We like to share the air around here, so to speak. And today I am fortunate enough to be speaking with our very own Jason Clayton. He's here to offer some exclusive insight into our Dream Trips Local experiences that I heard that you got to be a part of in Vegas. Is this correct?
I sure did, yeah. So I actually landed in Vegas a couple weeks ago, and we decided that it was a great opportunity for us to really get on board some of the entertainment merchants. Vegas was really such an extraordinary venue for us to actually get into that sector. So we started out on a VIP helicopter experience.
Wait, you said helicopter. Helicopter. I like that, though. Helicopter. So fancy.
And it was a pretty fancy event. So the members arrived. They actually had some champagne that they were greeted with as well before they departed on this extraordinary nightlife scene right above the strip. So we got to see the Bellagio, Caesar's Palace. It was pretty thrilling. It was my first ride, too. So... right above the grounds, and it was great to see the members really reflect on this awesome experience. So I got to sit right on the window, but I had this really amazing feel about the whole area in general. So you get to see the city. I actually took this ride just after our DT local launch party at the Stratosphere. So I left that party and was able to actually see the Stratosphere come within a few hundred feet of the actual building while the party was still going on. I would say if you're in Vegas, definitely take the nightlife ride because that really gives you such a great experience of Sin City, which is known for all of the bright lights, the neon signs. And so you really get that big perspective from a helicopter ride.
I love that. You know what would be even greater, though, is if you got to make your grand entrance to the party, jumping out of the helicopter with like a parachute
with
on your back.
With the tuxedo.
Yes. And that you just arrive. And you know what? If I didn't even know you and you just, you know, jumped off out of the helicopter, landed and brushed yourself off and just in your, you know, glorious fashion. Yeah. Just said, I'm here.
I'm here. Yes, I have arrived. And so
he has arrived.
And here's the champagne that comes with the experience as well. But essentially, it was a really great VIP experience. And that's what Dream Trips Local really aims to provide. And shortly after that, we actually took part of the Big Bus Tour. So Big Bus is actually one of our merchant partners as well. They're active in New York as well as Vegas. And so we actually departed right from Planet Hollywood, and it took us on a journey throughout some of the big landmarks in Vegas. All along the strip, we actually had the opportunity to take this photo op right by the Las Vegas sign, and members got a branded non-alcoholic beverage as well. So that was an additional touch that made the experience a lot more valuable.
I was looking on our Facebook page, and I saw that you got to sit behind... the wheel of a pretty nice car, is that correct? Maybe drive it a little bit?
Maybe drive it, absolutely, yeah. We actually landed at Speed Vegas, it's a DTL partner, and so our members got behind the seats of some European exotic cars, so from Lamborghinis to Maseratis, as well as the Audi R8. We had the opportunity to really get behind our dream car and take
Wait, was that your dream car, the Audi?
The Audi R8 was mine. Uh-huh. Yeah, it was a gorgeous red, crimson, beautiful, beautiful, stunning car. So Speed Vegas is home to the longest straight in North America, which means that you can really pick up some speed. So really exquisite location. And you could see in our members' eyes, this is really the first time that they had this experience. This was a really amazing opportunity to experience these thrilling cars. So our members really burnt some rubber, some serious rubber as well. And yeah, it was just an extraordinary experience overall. Yeah.
I would probably be terrified to put the pedal to the metal. I'd be the person going like, you know, 35. Like, oh, look,
that was me
corner.
As well.
Oh, really?
For a few feet. It's like, okay, is it moving? It's moving. Oh, okay. I'm really driving this thing. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Jason, thank you so much for taking the time to share your experience.
It was great, and I really thoroughly enjoyed that. And getting to meet the members as well is always a phenomenal experience. So thank you.
DreamTrips Local updates.
The more that we speak about DreamTrips Local, the more I realize that we've got such an incredible membership. If you could go anywhere for the holidays on a dream trip, where would that be?
Well, you know, personally, I enjoy being with my family on Christmas, and I know mm-hmm. that's beyond cheesy, but it's a tradition, and it's one that I truly cherish. Mm-hmm. Now, New Year's, if I could, yeah,
sure.
Right?
Where would you go for New Year's then? I mean, that's part of the holiday.
Mm-hmm. I'd probably go to Vegas, and that's not just saying that to relate back to, you know, what we talked about earlier, but because Vegas is the entertainment capital of the world. And it just sounds like so much fun. There's so much to do. So,
It is.
Yeah. And what about you?
You know what? I've got a wonderful 5-year-old daughter. And what I would always love to do would be to take her and my lovely wife to Disney World for the holidays.
Oh, my gosh. You're such a family man.
Yeah. You know, to see the lights and everything mm-hmm. and the wonderful Christmas parade they have, and to maybe have Christmas dinner with Mickey and Goofy Aww. And Pluto and all of the characters. And she could see all of the princesses that she loves. And
that's so wonderful. Does Lily want anything exciting for Christmas?
You know, she hasn't said yet that there's one thing in particular, just everything in general.
And Lily, by the way, Wayne's wonderful daughter, is the spitting image of him, but in beautiful, you know, 5-year-old
without
daughter
the mutton
form.
Chops.
Yes, without the mutton
without
chops.
The
but if you shave those off, yeah.
No. She's a lovely kid. I think she's beautiful like her mom.
Oh,
but
my goodness.
She's a great
she's
kid.
Hilarious.
She's a great kid.
I love her. Well, she's always excited.
But we've got a great Christmas gift for all of our members out there, haven't we?
We do. Well, we want to know about your holiday plans. If you're doing anything different or special or visiting another country that's different from yours, mm-hmm. we want to hear about it. We want to hear about your cultural experience. And we can now do that because we now have a voicemail that you can call and share with us your stories, your testimonials, you know, give
what you like about the podcast,
mm-hmm.
what you'd like to hear on the podcast.
Absolutely. But just make sure that it's about
The podcast
only.
Exactly. Yeah, because there's no replacement for if you do have a question about your membership, please do reach out to our customer care team mm-hmm. Because those guys really are phenomenal and they are the experts on it. Also, remember that if you do leave a message, that is giving us express rights to actually use your voice on the podcast.
Which is, I think it's super exciting because you get to hear me less. Isn't that great?
Anything that does that is a wonderment for
Aww.
Me.
Thank you for being a friend.
Always a friend. So what's the number, Hannah? Come on.
Okay. So it is 469-609-4898.
And I think there's really nothing much more to say on the podcast other than we hope everybody has a really wonderful holiday season, right, Hannah?
Absolutely. You know, have a fun and safe and wonderful holiday season, and we can't wait to hear about it on our new voicemail or Skype, or just reach out. We want to hear from you.
We've loved doing these first 9 episodes for you, and we can't wait to do a whole bunch more.
But I will say, and this is truly, and I mean this not to sound cheesy, but the number one gift that I feel like I've gotten this year was to be able to be a part of this podcast and get to know so many of you all. And I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart for letting me, you know, have this experience. It's been wonderful. And I am so looking forward to the future.
Well, you know what? Ditto. I'm just going to say ditto on that. because I really can't express it any better, and I feel exactly the same way about everybody.
Do you need a tissue? I feel like you're getting teary.
I know. I'm gonna cry. Well, we're gonna leave them on an upbeat note.
Yes, we will.
Have a holly jolly Christmas. It's the best time of the year.
Boom, boom, boom.
Oh, by golly, have a holly jolly Christmas this year. And remember, the best way to experience the world is together.
Bum 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 bum.
Jolly Christmas. It's the best time of the year. Oh, by jolly, have a holly jolly.
The Dream Trips Podcast.
Proceeding was a discussion about the benefits of the World Ventures Dream Trips membership and is meant for entertainment purposes only. Offers and benefits will vary by market and location. Members should refer to the DreamTrips.com website for terms and conditions of membership in their market and location.